Whatever, everybody. It's another surprise Sunday. I'm wearing blue glasses with a blue shirt with blue highlights in my hair. You could call me the genie's daughter. So, this past week, I watched two videos. One that made me cry, and the other one that made me think. The one that made me think was basically talking about how life is too short and that we need to be able to do everything that we possibly can because we might not get that chance ever again. In that video, it kind of talked about how we're not all truly ourselves, which made me start to think that is somewhat true. I feel like when it comes to people who are both in middle school and high school, we all need to put on this facade of who we not are. Like, we need to put on a facade. Almost through half my year of high school, I had to pretend that I liked rap. Do I like all rap? No. But there's some rap I like, but I don't like all types of rap. I don't care for Drake. I don't care for Chris Brown. I don't care for, there's just some rappers I just don't care for. But I just had to pretend because I felt like I was trying to fit in. The thing about trying to be yourself is that you have to at first find yourself. I think that I need to make this video because there's some people out there who aren't themselves. They're just pretending to be something that they're not, just so they can get into a group of kids who, when they get out of high school, are not gonna know 40 years later. I think that when you are yourself, then it makes you feel comfortable. You're comfortable in your own skin, you're comfortable in who you want to be, and you're comfortable just doing whatever it is that you like to do. So, without further ado, this is gonna be how to be yourself. Number one, like I said before, be comfortable in your own skin. I believe that the key to being yourself is knowing who you are first. I would probably suggest maybe go write a list of things that you're good at. If you write down all the things that you're good at, that way you can just be like, okay, I'm this, this, and this. Or just write down a couple of traits that you have, personality traits. Things that, you know, are you inside. And then after you study that, you're going to be like, okay. And also, while you're doing that, you got to learn how to be by yourself. I'm not saying don't disconnect everybody from your contact list or anything, or just go into like this deep depression or this deep type of, you know, self-isolation. I think just take some time just to be by yourself. Clear your head and just really think. Because when you're by yourself, you're thinking, oh, I'm this type of person. Or you're just taking time to just think about who you are. Once you find that out, you can move on to stage two. Stage two is doing something that you love. I believe that when you do something that you love, that means you're being yourself when you do it. Whether it be something that has to do with acting, could be science, could be math. I mean, you could be really good at ordering Chinese food. You could be awesome at breathing air. You could be just awesome at whatever. And once you realize that you're good at something, then you just become so self-aware that you're good at this that you just don't give an F, which leads to stage three. Stage three is basically not giving an F when everybody thinks. Like I said before, all my life I had to go pretending to be this person when really I just had to stop and think. It's like, wait, does this make you happy, Sierra? Does this make you who you want to be? No, it didn't. I just looked at myself in the mirror in disgust. I was dressing like everybody else when I wanted to dress a certain way. I was just being like every other kid. In fact, I'll give you a perfect example. I remember we were watching a video of the basketball, was it football or basketball player? I don't really remember. Who was beating his wife in the elevator and, you know, dragging her out. And the whole class was laughing. And I don't get why. Like, why would you laugh at something that's just so hurtful or just so uneasy to me to watch? And part of me felt like laughing too, but then I just said, stop. That's not who you are. Who I am, I'm a compassionate person. I have feelings for people. I try to do things to help people. I wouldn't dare laugh at anything that has happened to someone who was hurt. I wouldn't dare, because that's not who I am. But I was continuing to become this person who I didn't want to be, and I was just ashamed and appalled of. So what did I do? I made myself right now, because myself, my true self, loves Disney movies, loves talking about Disney movies. I love to dance when I'm by myself. I love to just pause movies and then do self-commentary. That's just something I like to do. And you know what? I don't give a crap what anybody thinks about that, because that's what I like to do. And that's the thing about being yourself, doing what you like to do and not caring what anybody thinks. And not putting on a facade just for people who, you know, you're not even gonna know in a couple years from now. So here's my challenge for anybody who's watching this and everybody who's watching this. I challenge you, if you have an outfit that you're just ashamed to just put on, wear it. If you are really like talented at something that you love, do it. If you have just these weird qualities about yourself, show them out. Show it to the world, because that's being yourself. That is who you want to be. And I'm sounding like a preacher right now. I think I should probably stop. I might do a poem version of this topic, because I feel like it just needs to be said. There's so many people out there that aren't themselves and are just pretending to be this person that they're not just to fit in. And that doesn't have to be the case. So to all of you that's watching this video right now, like I said before, I challenge you just to be yourself. Be who you truly are. Don't be what those people who you hang with want you to be. And one other thing that I want to point out is surround yourself with positive people. Don't surround yourself with people who are going to get you in trouble constantly, or it's just going to, you know, make your life miserable, or just going to talk you into doing stuff that you know you don't want to do, but you're trying to put on the facade. So just surround yourself with positive people. It could be your family, it could be your friends, it could be your dog, for crying out loud. Just surround yourself with good people, because they will encourage you to be yourself. Like I said before, I'm sounding like a preacher, and I will do a poem version of this topic, but yeah. So that's it for this video. Make sure you subscribe to my channel. I make new videos every Sunday. And that's it. I love you guys with peace and pizza. Bye.